We remember you and the God and told him to leave the land where he was living with his relatives. Abraham by faith decided to go. He did not know where he was going, but he decided to move by faith, believing the word of God, that God was faithful, who told him to move on. And the word of God says he moved on and he was living in the tents. And the word of God says he was looking forward to the city with the foundations whose architect and the builder is God. And he lived by faith. The word of God says by faith Sarah, his wife who was past childbearing age, was enabled to bear children. And the word of God says, from this man Abraham, who was as good as dead, came descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and the countries as the sand on the sea. I want to tell you, when we move in the faith, when we believe God, when we believe the word of God, when we move in the faith and take action, God will always come and to do something. Maybe you are there, you are very, very sick, you don't have any hope. Let me tell you this day, the word of God is able to heal you. God says, I am the Lord that healeth you, healeth thee. Also the word of God says, he sent his word, and the word healed us. I want to tell you, the word of God is able to heal you by faith this day. Believe the word of God, and God will raise you, and God will enable you to come out of that death bed. Wherever you are, you don't have hope. You believe in God. God is able, and God is going to do something, and is going to perform a miracle, as he did to his servant Abraham, who decided to walk by faith. In the word of God, there is also another man, at the Jewish centurion. This man was a commander of a section of an army, and he was a man in authority. He had soldiers that were below him, and they were under him, and he would command them to do something, and they would obey his command. When he told them, move and go there, they could do that without asking any question. When he told them to do something, they would believe without any question. And he was a man in authority, and he knew that authority works. And one time, his child, his daughter became very, very sick. And he knew that Jesus was able to heal the daughter. He knew that Jesus was the healer, and he could just say a word, and the daughter could get healed. And when he met Jesus, he told Jesus, my daughter is very sick. And the police just said the word, and my daughter will become whole. The daughter was at home, but this man, by faith he knew that if Jesus just said a word concerning the sickness of his daughter, the daughter could get well immediately. Because he knew if he was having servants under him and he would tell them, do this and that they could do, then he believed that even the word that Jesus could say was able to heal the daughter. And so he told Jesus, Master, just say the word and my daughter will be whole. And Jesus said, in the whole of Israel, I have never seen a man of faith like this one. And he told him to go. And immediately he went, he found that the child had already gotten well. The child had already gotten healed because of the word that he had, that Jesus has spoke. He knew that Jesus was able to speak the word, and the word was able to heal his daughter. I want to tell you, my friends, wherever you are watching and listening us from, when we walk by faith, when we believe God, God is able. There is nothing that is too hard for God. The word of God says, there is nothing impossible with the God. Let us believe God that things will turn out, that things will be better, that things will be good. Let us believe God that we are going to get out of the situation that we are in now. I know very many people, they are at home. Whatever they have been doing, it has been affected by the pandemic. Maybe your business has been shut down. Maybe you are having problems. You had the loans that you are supposed to pay, and now you don't know how you are going to service your loans. Maybe you are there. You are told to stay at home. You are not supposed to work. Your employer decided to tell you to move and stay. There is no work. Let me tell you, my friend, wait upon God. Stand by the word of God. By faith, God is going to turn things around because he is able. Let us believe God. And number four, as I finish, there is something that can help you. When you have reached at the end of the road, there is something that can help you. And this is having a humble and a contrite spirit. The word of God says, if we have a humble and a contrite spirit before God, God will remember us. In Psalms 51 verse 17, the word of God says, my sacrifice, O God, is a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart. You, God, will not despise. God will never despise a humble and a contrite spirit. When we are humble before God, when we humble ourselves before God, when God looks unto us and finds we have a humble and a contrite spirit, God will always remember us. And that is what helped David many a times, because David, despite having sinned before God, he had a humble and a contrite spirit. And this man could humble himself before God. He could cry before God. He could pray and cry and repent and wait upon God until God could see the humble state of his spirit. One time, David, when he was serving under King Saul, King Saul decided to chase David. He decided to kill David, and he was following David everywhere with the name of killing David. And one time, if you read the word of God, in the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 26, David was in the wilderness, and Saul decided to go with 3,000 soldiers to look for David. And when they went in the wilderness, they stayed Samuel And David sent his spies, and he knew where King Saul and his men were. And when it came at night, Saul with his soldiers decided to sleep. And when they slept, when they slept, David decided to go where Saul was sleeping. His bodyguard was there also asleep. His spear was there, and his water jug was there, and he was there sleeping. And David had gone there with one of his mighty men, by the men of Abishai. And when they found Saul sleeping, Abishai told David, "Let me just give me permission to take this spear that belongs to Saul and use it to kill him." And if Abishai said, "I'll only hit him once, not twice, and I'll pin him to the ground, and he'll die instantly." But David told Abishai, "No, we are not going to kill somebody who is anointed of the Lord." I want to tell you, David was so humble. He had a humble and a contrite spirit that he was not even able to kill his enemy who was looking forward to kill him. Here he was. He had the opportunity. Saul was here, deadly asleep, and the spear was there. The soldiers were asleep, the bodyguards were asleep, and David was there. He had the chance to kill his enemy, but he decided not to kill King Saul, because he said King Saul is an anointed servant of God, and he's not going to kill an anointed servant of God. And so he told Abishai, "Take the spear, take the water jug, the water mug for King Saul, and let us go." And they went. And when they went, and they were on the other side of the valley, they decided to shout, and Saul woke up. And David told Saul, "I was there, and I found you asleep, and I could not kill you. Although you were in my hands, I could not kill you. This is your spear, this is your water mug, jug I carry, and even your soldiers were not able even to guard you." I want to tell you, this man demonstrates a man that had a humble and a contrite spirit. And if somebody has a humble and a contrite spirit, God will remember you one time. When you call upon the name of the Lord, God will remember you one time. Moses, in Exodus chapter 32 and verse 31, Moses had to go to the mountain to take the commandments, the tablets of commandments. And when he came down after 40 days, he found the Israelites had already turned to worshiping an idol. They had already made a calf out of the jewels, and they were dancing around that calf, and they were worshiping that calf. And when he found them, the Bible says that it affected him so much. And he decided to ask God even for forgiveness for what they had done. And when he was praying to God, and he was telling God to forgive them, there is a statement that he said, and he told God, "Forgive them, Or if you don't forgive them, a priest brought my name out of the book of life for the sake of these people that have sinned against you. This man was able to tell God to brought his name out of the book of life because of the Israelites. He was so humble before God. Even the word of God says that for all the people that God created, there was none that was humble like Moses. He was a man that was able to talk to God as a man would talk with a man face to face. The man was so humble. He had a humble and a contrite spirit. And God remembered the Israelites. Paul, if you read the word of God in the book of Romans, you'll find that even Paul himself was a very humble man, a man that had a humble and a contrite spirit. In the book of Romans, I'm going to read just one verse as I conclude. Romans chapter 9, verse 1. I say the truth in Christ, I lie not. My conscience also bearing me witness in the Holy Ghost that I have great heaviness and continual sorrow in my heart. For I could wish that myself were accursed from Christ for my brethren, my kinsmen, according to the flesh. This is Paul, a man that had a humble and contrite spirit. And he was saying, I am speaking the truth in Christ. I am not saying or I'm not lying. My conscience is also bearing me witness in the Holy Ghost that I have great heaviness and continual sorrow in my heart. Why? And he said, for I could wish that myself were accursed from Christ for my brethren, my kinsmen, according to the flesh. This man had a great burden in his soul, in his spirit, concerning his brethren, the fellow Jews, the fellow countrymen. And he was saying, he better miss to go to heaven so that his countrymen, his fellow Jews, could have a relationship with Christ. That can only be said by somebody who is humble, by somebody who has a contrite spirit. And therefore, my brethren, my friends, I had about 5-6 points that I could have shared. Because of time, I'm not going to complete that message. But I want to tell you, my friends, those four items, if we practice them, if we do them according to the word of God, God will remember us. There is nothing that is too hard with God. Situations may be very hard. They may be very difficult. We may be undergoing a lot of problems, a lot of shortcomings. We may be pressed in the world. But I want to tell you, my brethren, those four things can help you. If you walk by faith, God will intervene in your situation. When you humble yourself and have a humble and a contrite spirit before God, God will come and change things to your own good. When you serve God with the faithfulness, with the wholeheartedly, God will also remember you. When you walk by faith, God will also remember you. And therefore, my brethren, I want to pray as I conclude the message of the day. And maybe you are there. You have not given your life to Christ. You have no personal relationship with the God through Christ. Because Jesus came and he died on the cross of Calvary, he died because of our sins. The word of God says, if we believe and confess with our mouth, God is faithful, he will forgive our sins, and he will make us, he will cleanse us, and we shall be able to become his children. The word of God says, you must be born again, so that you can see the kingdom of God. If you have not given your life to God, this day by faith, you can decide to receive Jesus as your personal Savior. I would kindly request you to pray this short prayer before me as I conclude. Please pray with me and say, Father in heaven, in Jesus' name, I know I am a sinner. I know Jesus died for me on the cross of Calvary. This morning, I have decided to follow you. Jesus, I repent of my sins, and I am asking for your forgiveness in Jesus' name. Sanctify my mind, my soul, my spirit, by the power of the blood of Jesus. And this day I declare, you are Lord, you are Savior in my life. I accept you as my personal Savior in Jesus' name. Thank you for praying that prayer. Want to pray as I conclude. My Father in heaven, I thank you for all those that have opened their hearts and by faith they have accepted you as Lord and Savior of their lives. Sanctify them, forgive them their sins, heal them and restore them, dear Lord. And from this day, give them the joy of salvation in the name of Jesus. Father in heaven, I remember many people that may be having some problems in their life. They could be very sick. Father, I pray that you may heal them. I speak and say the word of healing, the word of restoration upon them in the name of Jesus. Heal that man from the dead bed. Heal that man admitted in the hospital. Heal that man in the quarantine, dear Lord. Restore your people, even in many with other many needs, dear Lord. I pray that you may remember them, O God. Father, visit them with your word. Restore them, dear Lord. Provide them to their needs in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord. I give you glory. Remember our nation, O God. Heal our nation, Kenya, dear Lord. Heal us, dear Lord, and deliver us from the evil one, O God. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, I pray that you may give us a solution, even over this pandemic, O God. In the name of Jesus, stand against the plan of the devil. In the name of Jesus, come against the forces of darkness, the spirit of death, speak against you. In Jesus' name. And Father, I pray that you may intervene in our nation. Intervene, dear Lord, in the nations of the world. Move, dear Lord, to give an answer, to give a solution to this pandemic, O God, that have affected even the whole world. We thank you, we honor you. We give you glory, we give you praise. Thank you, Lord, for your presence. Thank you for being with us in this service, dear Lord. We worship you, we exalt you, we magnify your holy name. In Jesus' name, we pray, believing and trusting. Amen. May God bless you so much. Thank you for being with us. I believe you have been blessed. We have brought the word of God from Life Mission Christian Church in Naivasha, Kenya. We love you so much. May God bless you so much. And don't forget to tune again next Sunday from 10, and God will bless you. Have a wonderful day. May God bless you so much. Amen.